about it and realized that this whole adventure had been a terrible idea. "Crap bandit!" he screamed, and quickly retreated from the cave.
Jerk.
So, this thing is real, I guess. What should we do next? Get out of the cave? Yes. Get out of the cave. What in the water's name? The crap bandit's real. Yeah, I'm surprised too, you know. I must ask the old man more, the crazy old man more. He came here.
Wicked and Zeth.
Yes, he came here. How nice of him. Let's ask more. Discuss about the crap bandit. I saw a crab bandit. He was pretty beautiful, just like you. When you are dead. So, you saw him. It was really him. Did he have his fabled moustache of legend? All lords are down the great. You must seek counsel with him. If you can grant him the 3 tokens of gratitude, he will join forces with Galamir. Oh my god, this is pretty awesome. And our safety will be assured. So, he will be like an army for us, like a bodyguard. This is really cool. This is neat, actually. And, okay, so, let's work for it. 3 demands from a crab! From Mr. Krabs, that's worse. I really must have had crazy tonic this morning. Okay, let's go meet Mr. Krabs. Let's go. Okay, listen to his 3 demands. Lord Serdan, the great thought. Does the crab bandit even speak? Yes, does he speak? He can make other things that he speak. He carefully approached the crab bandit. Hello, he said to the beast. I'm here about the tokens? Gratitude tokens? Something like that? The crab bandit gestured towards his clothing. A tattered cloth around his waist and a sash across his chest. The crab bandit grunted loudly. The crab bandit tapped his walking stick loudly upon the cave floor. Okay. Crabs skittered from the back of the cave and looked up expectantly. The crab bandit looked at Lord Serdan the Great knowingly. Finally, the crab bandit, Mr. Krabs, lifted his claw to his face, gently stroking his magnificent moustache. Yes, I can see that. He's like, you know, how do they call it? From the past. This moustache is from the past times people have had this kind of moustache. And completely irrelevant, but Sir Daniel Fortescue in Medieval 2 also had to wear a moustache like this to get past a door that would check if he was another person. Okay, I'm sorry. He was, trying to be another person. A single tear rolled down his crabby chin. Single tear rolled down his crabby cheek. The requests were complete. Oh, the requests were complete. Huh. Okay, if you say so. Okay, so tell us what you did understand. Where did you end it? Where you concluded after all this madness? What in the world was all that supposed to mean? That's exactly my point. Ah, I have 3 question marks here. So, the crab bandit made some motion towards the smaller crabs. What action will Lord Serdan the Grey take? Could it be that his little crabs are hungry? I could bring them some food, I guess. Maybe some other crabs. Maybe he wants me to have one of his crabs to take as my ward. Someone told you this or you thought it by yourself? Actually, so I will check this one and go to the next one. The crab bandit seemed pained when he touched his moustache. What actions will Lord Serdan the Grey take? A glorious moustache like that clearly needs moustache wax. What the... is moustache wax? That's clearly what the crab bandit wanted. He could want a moustachoid sacrifice to appease him and his children. If he's misunderstood half man, half beast, I don't think that he wanted that. But if he wants that, he's not misunderstood anymore. So, I'm checking this. Arosh. Clearly the crab bandit... Okay, let's see here. I have two choices. What do they need? I'll have to make enough to fill... Oh no, don't go away, fill all those needy clothes. You may be something nice, blah blah blah. Clearly the crab bandit needs moustache wax. Someone must know where I can find wax fine enough for that glorious stash. Okay. Ask about moustache. Yes, let's ask about moustache. Oh, you mean Krabby Patty moustache. Mr. Plankton's. My moustache is modeled in the glory of the crab. I have the perfect wax recipe for it here. I'll write it down for you. Okay, please write me down the recipe. What is the recipe? Is it here? What is the recipe? This is Boo. It's not a recipe. You gave me poo? You mad bastard! So, Scott thinks Serdan is being friendly. So, let's check this. The crab bandit clearly gestured to his clothing. What action should Lord Serdan, the Great? Oh, okay, where? Take. I guess he wants a new pair of clothes. Maybe he didn't like my choice in. Maybe he didn't like my choice in colon. I guess I could buy something new. Yes, of course, this one. Yeah, this one. I've gotta find some clothes big enough for the crab bandit. I know the inventor with the landmines. Okay. So what's this? Let's talk to the inventor. Is this the one? Maybe. Request landmine shipment. Okay, let's do it. Follow King, zoom out, fast forward. Come on, Melisse. We have things to do, and I see that you're hungry too. So, really, you want them? I have more made right away. Do you have any other requests, my lord? Do I? Ask Inventor Charles for clothing. Okay, I want your clothes, Inventor Charles. Come on. Ask about clothes. Move it. So, my clothes. Well, okay, you are the king. Great, the crab bandit will love this, maybe. Great, the crab bandit will love this. Maybe. Okay. So, says here, deliver fat clothes to the king. It says here, make one moustache wax at the fireplace. Okay. And it also says I need to get a few things from the village shop to make the wax. And have one fowl soup in the inventory. Everyone likes a nice, hearty soup. Okay, so maybe. I don't know how to make moustache wax, but I will try to make it as it says in the fireplace. Let's go to the fireplace. Efren, put it out of here. Make food. Food? It's not a food.